Hey everyone, Adelman here. Today we've got another blacksmithing project for you. Today we're going to be making a corkscrew from a railroad spike. Stay with us. Just got to get those coals going good, then we'll turn the air on. Let's get this spike heating up. Alright, just gonna draw this out. Now, as I hammer, I'm going to start to round out the end of this. Because for our corkscrew, we need it to end up being rounded anyway. But just this end, not the whole thing. I'm just going to start a little bit. This will continue to draw it out. Center out. It's a little bit better so I can bend it a little bit easier. Now I'm going to put some bends right in the center here. Begin to shape our corkscrew. That's where we are now. Just need to exaggerate these curves and bring this back into the alignment there. I don't know if that was on camera or not. I don't think it was. So there's the general shape of our corkscrew now. Now, what I like to do, this part I'm pretty happy with. Down here, I'm going to thin this out a little bit more, draw it out. We're going to make a little corkscrew. Hopefully, this does not break. Got to be very, very careful now. Here we go. I'm just going to finish drawing out the end here. You know, I thought this is going to be a relatively quick and easy project. You know, draw out the spike. Put a few bends in it. Done. But no, I don't think so, Kimosabe. Everything needs to take longer. You run into problems, you have issues. But in the end, hopefully, it all works out. Alright. So that's where we we are now. I'm gonna do that again, maybe two more times, we will see. Almost got it. Almost got it that time. Oh, so close. That pulls off so darn quick. Alright. Flatten this and wait for him to pull this done. Be really careful on those fork screws now. Alright, I am going to call this done, guys. So I'm just going to throw this in the forge, heat it up one more time, a little bit, quench it just to make it look nice. Put a nice dark finish on there. I don't want it to be too hard. I don't want this to be brittle, but I'm going to let it cool off a little bit and then quench it. All right, here's the transformation when it gets out of that quench there. It looks quite different, quite nice and cleaned up. So, hope you guys enjoyed this project. I'm really happy with how it came out. See you next time on Animal Man Survivor. If you haven't yet, hit that subscribe button. Thanks, guys.